to understand a few things, okay? Because we started rate law. I will give you some hints in between the class. So the last point that we wrote in yesterday's class was regarding the rate constant, okay? Regarding the rate constant. And we wrote that, okay, there are a few people in the, yeah, rate constant. So we wrote that the last point was K depends on, K depends on nature of reactant, right? And then it depends on temperature. And also, what is the last point, Mariam? You didn't write the notes or what, Mariam? Yesterday, Mary was absent. Okay. Amalia is here. Nazira is also here. Nazira, how are you? You joined yesterday's class, but after a while, you got disconnected or you left? I hope I am audible. Yes, hello guys. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, okay. Mariam, are you there? What is the third point? The rate constant depends on? Yes, I am also good, Nazira. Thank you. Okay, it seems Mariam is not here. Okay. So the last point is catalyst. Those who were present yesterday, they are absent today. And those, okay, Amalia is also, Amalia, you are joined with two devices. Yes, Amalia, how are you? You were also absent yesterday. What happened? Write a note. Rate constant does not depends on, does not depends on the concentration. Concentration of reactant. Oh, you went to the hospital. Okay. Okay. Right. Let us start now. Units of rate constant. Okay. So all of you will write from here. Those who are present, they all will write from here. You will understand from here. Okay. You will understand from here. Please try a bit and you will understand. So the topic is units of rate constant. Rate constant. Okay. First of all, we will write the rate law equation. Most of you would have seen this equation. R is equal to K A to the power N. Yes, Fatima, Nazira, Sania, Amalia. Have you seen this equation previously?
Yes, sir.
Yes, na? You have seen this equation. What about others? Fatima?
Yeah, I guess.
Yeah, you guess. Okay. So in this, I hope that you know this is the rate of reaction. Okay, this is ROR, rate of reaction. This is the rate constant. This is the rate constant. This A term in square brackets is the concentration of reactant. This N term here, it is the order of reaction. It's order of reaction. Now, as we know, now we are going to calculate the rate constants unit. So first we will write what is the unit for rate of reaction. So rate of reaction is change in concentration. So it will have concentration per unit time divided by time, right? Divided by time. And this is equal to K will be K because we are going to find the, we are going to determine the unit of K. Then we have A. What is A? A is concentration. Okay. A is concentration. So concentration, we'll write concentration like this. but this is concentration to the power n. So what will be k? K will be equal to, the concentration will go to the denominator, so we will have concentration here like this divided by concentration to the power n, where n is the order of reaction, and here we have into 1 by t. Please tell me, everyone understood how did we get this particular expression? K is equal to concentrate for units. Okay, this is only for units. Concentration. Yes. Okay. Abir, we are doing units of rate of rate constant. We just wrote the things that we ended up in the last class, that K depends on. After that, we started rate constant. In this, we have started with rate is equal to the rate of expression. Rate is equal to rate constant into concentration to the power order. And rate is having unit, concentration upon time. K, we are going to determine the unit for K. So K is like this only. And A is concentration to the power N. Now we have got K is equal to concentration divided by concentration to the power N. That is why I can say K is equal to concentration to the power 1 minus N. Because here this is 1. When exponents are in division, we subtract, we can subtract them, right? 1 minus N. And this will be T inverse, right? 1 upon T is T inverse. So concentration is in terms of mole per liter, 1 minus N. T will be in terms of second inverse. So this is the general, this is the general unit for rate constant if the order is N. Okay, this is the unit for rate constant when order of reaction is equal to n. So please copy this. Okay, Abir, I will scroll up. From here, right? Units of rate constant. Do let me know if I can scroll down. Fatima is done. Anya is also done. Yes. Abir, can I scroll down?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So just waiting for Abir and Maryam. I don't know whether Maryam is in the class or not. Okay. So Maryam, you are here, but you are not replying. Yeah? Okay. Amalia is also done, na? I saw that Amalia raised hand for a while. Yeah, she is also done. Okay, just waiting for Abir now. And all right. Now we know the unit for rate constant when the order is equal to 1. Now let us see when. For reaction, for zero order reaction. That means the order in which the order is zero, the reaction in which order is zero. For zero order reaction, n is equal to how much? N will be equal to zero. N will be equal to zero. And hence, the unit will be the unit of K. This will be equal to mole liter inverse, right? 1 minus 0 will be what? 1 minus 0 will be 1 and second inverse. So we'll have to just write mole liter inverse, second inverse, right? For zero order reaction, N is equal to 0. Unit of K will be this one. For first order reaction, N is equal to 1. The unit will be equal to mole liter inverse. What should I write in the exponent, Fatima? N is equal to 1. Please see here and tell me.
1.
Only 1? This is 1 minus N, na? So substitute here 1. So it will be 1 minus 1, right? Yes or no, please, guys.
Yes.
Please pay attention. This will be mole liter inverse to the power 0 and second inverse. So tell me, what will be the unit for first order reaction? Nazira, what will be the unit of K for first order reaction?
Negative 1 and second raised to negative 1.
Wow, great. Anyone else who wants to try? You guys are not paying attention. Okay, somebody has answered, I guess. Yes, Abir, yeah, correct, Abir. Okay, Ahmed has also joined right now. Very good. Everyone is late. We have 1 hour class and everyone is late also. Very good. Okay, let me plug in my earphone. Okay, you are also sick. What is happening? You can leave the class. You can attend the class. I don't force you, Ahmed. Okay, let's say, Amalia, can you please tell me what will be the unit of K for first order reaction?
Second inverse.
Okay, you are Amalia?
No, I thought of giving an answer before leaving the class.
Okay, so this will be second inverse. I hope, Nazira, did you understand? Why this will be second inverse? Because mole liter inverse to the power 0. This will become 1. Yes or no? Nazira? Anything to the power 0 is equal to 1. So this whole thing here, this will get 1. Because the power is 0. Yes? Okay, very good. Now let us move on to... Please pay attention, guys, for second order reaction, N is equal to 2. The unit will be mole liter inverse 1 minus 2 second inverse. So this will be mole and we will have liter inverse. And here we will have 1 minus 2 will be minus 1 second inverse, right? Minus 1 second inverse. So we can write this minus 1 will get here. This will mole will become mole inverse. Liter inverse will become 1 minus 1 into minus 1. This will be plus 1 second inverse. Okay. So this is the unit of K when the order is 2.
Netuka.
Mute your Ahmed.
Yes, sir.
Yes, please write this question. Tell the answer in chat. For a reaction, it was found that the units of K, the unit of rate constant, is same as the unit of rate of reaction. Determine the order of reaction. Okay. Write this question. Send the answer in chat. A, B, C, or D. Yes, Fatima, very good. Correct. Yes, yes, correct. I got that. You have 1 more minute. Please identify until this is very easy. Okay. Yes, Amalia, very good. Are? Sanya, did you understand the question? Yes, Sanya. Yes, Abir, correct. Yes, Amariam. Now tell me, Sanya, what will be the answer? Yes, Sanya. See, they have asked for a reaction that was found that the unit of K is same as the unit of rate of reaction. First, we have to know what will be the unit for rate of reaction. So, rate of reaction we have already seen. It is equal to concentration per unit time. Okay, concentration and second inverse, that is mole, liter inverse, second inverse. Now, thus, what you have to do, you have to correspond this particular unit to the units of rate constant. Yes. So the unit of rate constant is the zero order reaction. It has the same unit as that of rate of reaction. So B is the answer. B is the answer. Okay. I'll write another question. Let us say. Okay. So this a simple question. This is for those who were absent yesterday. So for a reaction. A plus B giving products. The rate law is. The rate law is given to be R is equal to K into the concentration of A to the power 1/2. B to the concentration, sorry, A to the power of 1/2 and B to the power of 2. What is the order of reaction? What is the order of reaction? So see, first I will write what is order of reaction. Okay. So order of reaction. Please write this, everyone. Order of reaction. It is the sum of powers of concentration terms in the rate law expression. In the rate law expression, okay. So here we see that the concentration power is 1/2 and this is 2 here. What is order of reaction for this reaction? Order will be equal to the sum of the power, right? So it will be 2 plus 1 by 2. That will be the answer. This is 2 half, right? This is equal to 2.5. Now write another question. The question is, the reaction X giving Y follows second order kinetics. Follows second order kinetics. If the concentration of X is increased, three times, how will it affect the rate of reaction? How will it affect the rate of reaction? Please write this question. Then we will solve this. Okay, Mariam, are you done writing the question? Oh, Mariam was so present yesterday. No, not Mariam. Fatima, are you done writing the question?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, do you understand how to do this or?
X raised to 3 is equal to Y.
Okay, yeah. So, yeah, you're going in the right direction. See, first of all, what you will do, you will write the rate rate law. So they have said that it is second order. So we will write R is equal to K. We don't need any of these things. We will just write R is equal to K into the concentration of X to the power. What will be the power, Fatima? No idea? Yes, Fatima, tell me. R is equal to K into the concentration of X to the power. What is the order? Second order. So in the concent, the power is the concent, sorry, the power is the order. That is why this will be 2. Somebody gave the answer. Yes, Sanya, very good, correct. Now, this is the concentration. Now, what I will do initially, let concentration of X be, let us say X only, okay? The concentration of X be X initially. So what will be the rate? So R1 is equal to K into the concentration, that is X. Let me write it like this first. The concentration of X to the power 2. This will be equal to K. What is the concentration of X? It is X. This will be KX square, right? So this is the R1. Now, after that, what happened? And when concentration is increased, how many times, Fatima?
3 times.
So, therefore, the concentration of X will be how much in terms of small x? 3x, right?
Yes.
Now the concentration is 3x. So now this is the rate 2 because we are doing another experiment here. The rate constant will not change because you remember in the first thing we have wrote in this class, what is the note? Rate constant does not depend on the concentration of the reactant, right? So the rate constant will be the same. The rate constant will be same thing. R2 is equal to x to the power 2. Now this will be equal to k. Now this x is how much? 3x whole square. This is your r2. Now what they have said, how will it affect the rate? Now you will do, take the ratio r2 by r1 is equal to, what is r1? R1 is kx square divided by, now this will be equal to k into 9x square, right? This will be k into 9x square. Oh, r2 is, sorry, I messed up with the, so this one is 9x square and this is x square. Now we can eliminate these things. We can eliminate the x square and the x square. We can eliminate the r and k and k. And we can say that r2 is equal to 9 times of r1. Any doubts, anyone?
Sir, can you scroll up?
Yeah, yeah, sure. From the answer, no? You want the question also?
No, sir. This one, answer.
Answer only, no? Okay. Done, Abir.
Yes, sir. Finish.
Okay. I hope I can scroll down. Everyone is done, I guess. Yes, Fatima, Nazira?
Yes, sir.
Done, no? Okay, great. All right, another. Okay. That's right. Similar type of question. A reaction is second order with respect to 3 reactant. How is the rate of reaction affected when part A is when concentration of reactant is doubled, B part is halved. I will give you 2-3 minutes. Yes, Abir, I have just got A, nothing else. Fatima, okay. So for the doubled one, it is what second order kinetics, right? This is second order kinetics. Now, if it is second order kinetics, then I can write, let us say we have a reaction like this, reactant is forming products. So rate of reaction will be equal to K into the concentration of reactant to the power 2. And let's suppose that initial concentration, initially, in the first case, okay, case is, yeah, means initially, that R is equal to A. The concentration of R is equal to A. So rate of reaction will be equal to K and the concentration of R, the square, so be R into K A square. Now, when concentration of R is doubled, it is 2A now. So rate of reaction will be equal to K into the concentration of reactant into the power 2. This will be equal to K into 2A square. This will be K into 4A square, right? So this is R1. This is R1. This is R2. It's R2. Now R2 upon R1. This will be equal to how much? And this is K4A square. And this is KA square. So A square and A square will cancel. K and K will cancel. And we will get that R2 is equal to, R2 is equal to 4 times R1. Okay, not 2 times Fatima, 4 times, because it is second order. Okay, this is something that you have to keep in mind. Similarly, when it is half, again, we have the same reaction. Reactant is giving some product. And the rate of reactions R into the rate constant K, the reactant. And this is half. The only change is this is was 2 and this is half. Nothing else we have changed. Okay. So R1 is equal to, let us say K. In the initial concentration is also, let us keep it A only. So A to the power by, this will be A root 2. Na? This is R1 is equal to K A root 2. Now, in the second case, what is happening? The reactant is half. So this is A by 2. This is A by 2. So what will happen now? Oh, no, sorry. This is not half. Sorry, this is not half. This is 2 only. Because we cannot change the order, right? We cannot change the order. This will be A square only. Now, this is half, right? This is half. So the rate of reaction, that is R2, it will be equal to K into the concentration of R square. This will be K. The concentration of R is A by 2 square. So R2 is equal to K into A square by 4. So I can write R2 upon R1. Here in this case, it is equal to how much? This is K and we have A square, this divided by 4. And for R1, we have KA square, right? So this KA square and KA square will cancel out each other. We will get R2 is equal to R1 upon 4, right? R1 upon 4. So these are the two answers. When you are doubling it, it is 4 times. When you are halving it, it is 1 by 4 times the initial rate of reaction. And also it is quite visible if you write the rate, if you write the rate law, R is equal to K into the concentration of R to the power 2 because it is second order. Now, when I write R square, that means when I will double the concentration, the rate of reaction will quadruple. That means it will become 4 times. If I halve the reaction, if I halve the concentration of reaction, the rate of reaction will decrease by 4 times, right? It will decrease by 4 times. So it is quite visible from this rate of reaction also. But this is a mathematical procedure. I am doing this only because you have a subjective examination for term 2 and this chemical kinetics sentence is in terms 2. Otherwise, for MCQ, you don't need this solving part. If you see the rate law expression, the order, then you can easily determine the answer. Okay. So raise your hand when if you are done. We will do one last question. And in this, we will determine the order of reaction. We will be given some reactions, the initial concentration of A, the initial concentration of B, the rate of reaction, and from those experimental data, we will determine the rate law expression because you know that rate law is only determined experimentally, it is not a theoretical process. So you will be given experimental data from which you will determine the rate law expression. Tell me if you are done. Raise your hand if you are done, okay? Fatima, what did you put? Did you put one here?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Okay. Abir is done. Fatima is done. Amalia, Mariam, Nazira, Sania. Okay, Mariam and Nazira, waiting for you guys. Okay, just waiting for Nazira now. Okay. Let us write the question. Let me just write it like this. From the following data. Determine the rate law expression. Determine the rate law expression. That means they are saying determine the rate law expression, but indirectly what they are asking, you have to determine the order of reaction, right? Order of reaction. So they have said that the reaction is with A and B and it is giving you some products. They have given the initial concentration of A and B, and then they have gave you the rate of reaction, what it is. Then they change the initial concentration, and after that, they showed you the rate of reaction. Then they again change the three expressions you have been given, three data values, three set of experiments. So let us write it like this. A is given in terms of mole per liter. Okay, this is the concentration of A which is given. Okay, concentration of A in the first experiment was 0.20. So the first experiment, the concentration of B was mole liter inverse. And we had 0.30. Okay. Now the R naught. So what is this R naught? R naught means the initial concentration. Okay. This initial rate of reaction. This will be in terms of mole per liter second inverse, because this is the rate of reaction initially. The rate of reaction was found to be 5.07 into 10 to the power minus 5. Okay. Into 10 to the power minus 5. Now this is for the first experiment. Okay. This is for the first set of experiment. Now, those who were present yesterday, they will have a bit of idea how these values are determined. Yes, Abir?
Yes.
Okay. Now, this is the first experiment. Now, in the second experiment, they changed the initial concentration. They kept the initial concentration of A as 0.20 only. They changed the initial concentration of B to 0.10. Now they were seeing now how the B is affecting the rate of reaction. Okay. What is the change that will happen in the rate of reaction if we change the concentration of B, and specifically we are lowering the concentration of B, we are keeping the concentration of A constant. And it was found out to be 5.07 into 10 to the power minus 5. Okay. Now tell me, is there any effect if we change the concentration of B? Yes or no? No, na?
Yes, sir.
There is no change, because whether it is 0.30 or whether it is 0.10, the rate of reaction is same one. Now, this is something that you have got qualitative idea about the rate of reaction. Okay. Now, we will do some calculation. In that, you will also get the quantitative idea also. Okay. How does this no affect? What does it mean in terms of order of reaction? Okay. After that, in the third experiment, the concentration of A was changed to be 0.40 and the B was again decreased to be 0.05, and the rate of reaction was 1.43 into 10 to the power minus 4. Okay, so these are three sets of reaction. Please write this. I hope you were writing. Did you not? Yes, Abir, are you done?
once again. Yes, sir. Done.
Now, the first thing that you will do is write the rate law expression. Okay, write the rate law expression. So we will write a simple rate law expression as rate is equal to, there will be some rate constant k, and it will also depend on the concentration of a to the power. Let us write something. Let us write m. Okay, we don't know the m, and also b to the power n. Okay, we don't know this m and n, right? Rate law expression we can write. The only thing in the rate law expression is the concentration of reactant to the order, right? To the power, and that power is order. So we have to determine this m and this n. These m and n we have to determine. So for first reaction, for R1, please see and tell me if I can write it this or not. It is equal to how much? 5.07 into 10 to the power minus 5. And this will be equal to the concentration. What is the concentration for A here? The concentration of A is equal to 0.2 to the power m and 0.3 to the power n. Please tell me, guys, if you understand this. And now I'm writing the rate for the second experiment, 5.07 into 10 to the power minus 5. Here the concentration of A was seen, that is 0.2 to the power m, and concentration of B was changed to be 0.10. I will write 0.1 to the power n. Yes, Abir, Nazira, Fatima. Did you guys understand how I'm writing these expressions? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, okay. Now R3 is equal to 1.43 into 10 to the power minus 4. Now this will be equal to how much? The concentration of A was given to be 0.4 in the third experiment, right? 0.40 to the power m. And we have here 0.05. to the power n. Yes or no? So let us say this is the equation first, this is equation 2, and this is equation 3. Okay, this is equation 3. So you have got three equation, and from here you have to find these powers of m and n. Now what you have to do, you have to identify those equation in which you can cancel one of the reactant. For example, look at reaction 1 and 2. If I divide 1 and 2, let's divide like this. R1 divided by R2 is equal to 5.07 into 10 to the power minus 5 divided by 5.07 into 10 to the power minus 5. This will be equal to, what is the R1? R1 is 0.2 to the power m, 0.3 to the power n divided by 0.2 to the power m and 0.1 to the power n. Yes? Yes or no, tell me. Now, what are the things that I can eliminate? This can be eliminated by this. You will get one here. This whole can be eliminated by this, because see, a to the power x divided by a to the power x, whatever a and x are, they can also cancel each other, and you will get what? One. Okay, you will always get one. So you have got this as one. What we have got here? You have got, okay, now also what we can do, we can write it like this. One is equal to 0.3 divided by 0.1 whole to the power n. Yes, because 0.3 is also power n, 0.1 is also to the power n. Now, moving on, this can be cancelled. This is 3 times. So I can say 1 is equal to 3 to the power n. Now, 1 is equal to 3 to the power n. Now, you have to determine what will be n. What will be n here? Now, can somebody tell me? I'm saying 3 to the power n is equal to 1. Now determine n. Nazira, what will be n? Don't, huh? Okay, somebody gave the answer. Yes, Abir, correct. Nazira, okay, Fatima, what will be the value of n if 3n is equal to 1? Can you speak, Fatima? No. What about Amalia?
Zero.
Yes, correct. Zero. Nazar, it will be zero, na? 3 to the power n is equal to 3. So this is not correct. 3 to the power 0 is equal to 1. Amalia just keep on waiting, right? She keeps on waiting. So from here, we can say that this implies that n is equal to 0. N is equal to 0. Now, please see the qualitative idea that we got from the experiments only, that if we are changing the concentration of B, there is no change in the rate of reaction. That means obviously this N is equal to 0, and that is why N does not have, sorry, the B does not have any effect in the rate of the reaction. Okay, B does not have any effect on the rate of the reaction. We have determined N. Now we will determine M also. Now we will determine M also. And what we can do here is, we know that N is equal to 0. Now we can determine from any of these. Nah? So we will do R2 by R3. Let's do, or rather R3 by R2. That is more better. R3 by R2. What is the rate? It is equal to 1.43, I guess. 1.43 into 10 to the power minus 4. And this was the same 5.07, right? 0.07 into 10 to the power minus 5. This was equal to, we had here 0.4 of M and divided by 0.2 of N. And here we had 0.05 of N. And here we had 0.10 of N. Now, as we know, N is equal to 0. So I can write it like this. Can I write it like this? .07 into 10 to the power minus 5. This is equal to 0.4 divided by 0.2 whole to the power of M. Because as we know that N is equal to 0. That is why this whole term will become 1. This whole term will become 1. This whole term will also become 1. Now, we have this can be eliminated, and this will be 2. So we'll write 2 to the power of M. 2 to the power of M, right? We will get 2 to the power of M is equal to 14.3 into 10 to the power minus 5 divided by 5.07 into 10 to the power minus 5. So this will cancel each other. We will get 2 to the power M is equal to 14.3 divided by 5.07. Calculate this. This will be 5 threes are 15. It'll be 2.8 or 2.6. Whose mic is on? Please turn it off. 2.7 or 2.8, something near that it would be. Let me check this. 14.3 divided by 5.07. This is 2.82. Okay, so 2 to the power of M, we have got this as 2.82. Now what are we going to do? Now we will take log of 2 to the power M is equal to log of 2.82. Now this will be M log 2 is equal to log of 2.82. Now M is equal to log of 2.82 divided by log of 2. So log of 2, so I remember. Log of 2.82, I have to calculate. Okay, this is approximately equal to 0.45. Log 2 is 0.30. Okay, so this can be divided by, this will be 2 and this will be by 3. 45 by 30, it will be 3 by 2. This is approximately equal to 1.5. So we have got M and we have also got N. N is equal to 0. M is equal to 1.5. Now we can write the rate law expression. R is equal to K into the concentration of A. This has the order 1.5 and B has the order 0. Okay, so the rate law expression will be equal to K into A to the power 1.5. That's it. Order with respect to A is equal to 1.5. Order with respect to B is equal to 0. So this is the answer. This is one of those questions, I guess, which involves law. There is one more question in NCERT. Not one more. There is few more questions in NCERT, which has the same basis that you have to identify the rate expressions which can be divided, and then we can get the order for the other one. For example, here we had 3, and in these 3, we can identify that if we divide 1 by 2, then we can eliminate these things. We can eliminate these, right? And then we can determine the value of N. And after we have determined the value of N, then we can put in the R2 by R3, and then we can determine the value of M also. Okay. Is everyone done writing, or is there anyone who has to write?
So last line.
Last line. You have class on Wednesday, right? This is, I guess, 10th question in NCERT. You have to do homework, okay? Please. You have to do only one question, that is 4.11. Okay, 4.11. And that also you have to obtain the rate law. Then you can also find the rate constant, but if you obtain the rate law, that much also is fine, okay? And send me the answer, okay?
Send. Sir, what is the page number?
Page number, go to exercises, na? Exercises, chapter 4 exercises.
Okay, sir.
You all will send the answers to Nishkar sir. Okay. Did you hear all of you? Can you please raise your hand? Thank you, Fatima, Sanya, Abir. Others did not. Okay, Amalia. Maryam, Nazma. Okay. So can you please see that question, Abir? Did you find it?
Yes, sir.
It has a table.
Yes, sir. There are four results.
Four, na?
Yes, yeah, sir.
There are four experiments. Okay, fine. So we will meet on Wednesday. Before Wednesday, please send me the answers, okay? Please send me the answers.